Hello, hello, hello. You know what that sound is? That's the sound of Dragonhead Gaming coming to you from Homebrew Vehicle Sandbox. If you know that sound, that means it's time to fight aliens. Today we're going to do a blimp tutorial so that you can fight those aliens off. Come over here. We're going to choose a new vehicle. Blimp tutorial. Let me spell that properly. There we go. Alrighty. Now for the blimp, first thing we want to do is we want to build our base. So I start with two line nines. They go off either way this way. And then two line nines right in the center here. Alright, then we're going to make a pipe. You just go here. Double click, or click and then double click, and it is a 25 by 25 grid, so we're just going to make a line 25, click and then double click to close it. We're going to save that as line 25. Come back in here. Now I'm going to want to, previous page, I want to print off four of those. Attach them along the ends here like this. Alright. Now that's the basis. Now we want two curve fives. We're going to close off the front end. Make sure those are facing inwards. Come to the back end. Drop two more. There we go. Alright, now I want to go in here. I want to get two line fives. One right there. And one right there. As you can see, it's beginning to overlap. I'll throw up a circle right there. The reason is that gives us a single mount in the middle while still keeping the center of gravity even. And then we want to close it off again on this side. Alrighty. Now, we're going to attach our engines. And for that, we're going to use two hovercraft propellers. Alright, we want to find the bottom. So go ahead and click right there, and you're going to want to attach one right here. Face those downwards. And it will go down into the map. We'll fix that later. And then attach the other one right there. And then you should have two downward facing ones. Okay. Now we're going to lift it up. Right over here, this green arrow, if you click that, you see how that lifts it up? Now we can see where our vehicle is. And the nice thing about doing the two hovercraft engines like that, let's go ahead and bake this, I'll show you. If you come into here, so this will be the bottom and base of your blimp. If you turn on gravity, it's a perfect base. It's nice and round, it's even, which makes for landing a lot easier. Alright, now, let's see. So the front of our vehicle is over here. So I want to put on my seat. Let's go over here to parts. Alright. I don't want to stick out too far out to the front end. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to attach the front. Oh, wait. Nope. I did the wrong end. Just ignore the man behind the microphone. All right. I'm going to take the end and put it on the end there. That's right. Because we don't want to overlap into the engine. All right. So now we have our seat. We want to attach a gyroscope to it. Two batteries, just two single batteries, and this will just make it a little more stable with your turning and stuff. And I normally just attach this. right off the front. And then attach the batteries directly to the seat. There we go. Alright, now we want to add two fuel tanks. I normally just add them right there. Make that small, or face down. And then put the other one right on the other side. There we go. And it's like one big extended fuel tank. Alright, bake that, and we're going to look at our center of gravity. And as you can see, our middle's here, and it's forward because of our seat. And we'll eventually, when we add weights and that, even that back out. Alright, now we're going to start building the frame. Okay, so what we want to do is we're going to build a new pipe, because we're going to build a pipe that goes from up here straight up with a mount on the side and then to the middle. So we're going to go in here. We'll start at the bottom. Now we're going to want to go up, probably around 10. So 2, 3, and remember this does count as block 1 when you're doing your spaces. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Oops, double click. And then we're going to close it off to add one, and then we're going to double click again. And then we're going to make a curve from here. Now, because it goes in 9, we're going to want to go ahead and take that actually 10, so we have that center joint. So 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. There we go. Now we're going to call this rib piece, or you can call it whatever you want. And, oops, wrong one. We're going to go in there. Oh, that's what I was afraid of. Oh well. Thought I saw that just in the last second. Alright, now as you can see, it's going to bring it right up in the middle. And then we'll attach one over there. And as you can see, it leaves just the single joint in the middle. And then we're going to do this here again. This one right in the middle, and right in the middle, and then make sure they're facing inwards, and then the last one. All right, and that is our frame. Now we want to go back to the line 25s, and we're going to do off 6 of those so we can close that off. Okay, so we take this one, put it right across the top there, and right there. Now you do, when you attach these, you want to make sure that you attach them either all on the end like I am, or attach them all in the middle. If you attach some here and some here, it will throw the weight of your vehicle off. Alright, and we have a fully enclosed vehicle now. And eventually I'm hoping we'll be able to add plates for armor, and you can put this actually inside here so it's fully protected, just do everything off of monitors. I'm really looking forward to the more additions and more parts they add to the game. Alright, now let's go ahead and add our helicopter wings Pro. You're going to want to drop four of those. And these are strictly for weapon mounts. So one right there. One right there. Just turn that around. Then we're going to want to do the same thing on the other side. Yeah, I probably should have dropped them over here, but... because I don't want to go all the way back over there. Let's see, you want to put it in the same spot. Right there. So, now we have our weapon mounts. Let's go ahead and drop some Hellfires on there. These are great for auto-tracking the aliens. As you can see, just fits in there perfectly. Didn't think that would work, but I thought I would try it this time. Because we don't want the missiles actually hitting each other, because I have had that happen. All right, let's clean that up. We'll put that down here on this one. All right, and they should be mounted up. All right. And then let's put a gun What kind of gun? Let's do the 30. Let's see, we're going to want to attach that top. As you can see where it comes out, so we're going to count that as the top front. I'm going to click that one. We're going to put it right there. Face it forward. Do the same thing on the other side. So we want to figure out which side is the top, so it's going on this side. So top, that middle one, and attach. Alright, that'll give us some forward firing guns. We have our Hellfires. Let's go ahead and add two more on the other side. Let's best it up. Around. Don't want to have it pointing behind us. We have separate ones for those, because you'll be able to engage targets both in the front and to the rear. Alright. That looks good. Let's go ahead and bake that. Face. Now we got that center of gravity way up front. But right now you have a lot of firepower up front. And we can always add weights to the back to counteract that. And we still have to put our engines on. And all right, so with this, I'm going to go ahead and add the blimp. And we'll start working on that. Whew, push me out of the way. Okay, and you're going to want to look for these right here, where there's a whole bunch. Click the middle. We're going to come right up here and click right in the middle there. Then look at it. As you can see, this is facing the front. Now, we actually want to turn that around. There we go. Now the blimp is proper. Now if we go in here, bake it, come into here, if we turn the... it's going to fly off because it's so light right now. But as you can see, that front end... I'm going to do a slow-mo for you. As you can see, that front end there just stays heavy, the back end flies off. And we'll be adding stuff to make that more even. Alright, so we want to add our forward momentum engines. Oh, let me look at one thing real quick. Before you add the engines, you want to kind of look where your center of gravity is. See how low we are? So we're going to kind of want to keep the engines right along this plane. And that'll keep you from going up and down too much, and it'll keep your altitude where you want it. So if you want to move fast, you can put two engines on. We're just going to do one here for the tutorial. There we go, plane propeller. I'm just going to attach this right off the back end here in that middle slot. I'm going to bake it, and that's going to show me where my center of gravity is. And if you look, it's right here. If we follow that along, it's almost perfectly even. So when that engine's pushing behind us, it's going to give us just maybe the slightest bit of lift, not much at all. And then we'll make this heavy so that it naturally just sinks, so that way we don't float away up in the air. All right. Now let's go ahead and add a couple more fuel tanks, since we've added more engines. And I'm just going to attach those. I'd say probably right there's good. Not in the way of anything. And one to the other side, because we want to keep everything balanced. Let's bake it, look at our center of gravity. As you can see, it's slowly creeping forward. Okay, so we now have essentially one gas tank for every motor plus an extra. But we still have to put our rocket engines on. And instead of using ballast, I like to use fuel tanks, just to have that little extra bit of fuel. Alright, so let's go ahead and we're going to put our rocket engines on. And the reason I like to use these are awesome for turning, much better than the blimp wings. I tried the blimp wings, and it's great if you want a nice standard blimp that drives slow, but we're doing an alien fighter blimp here. So we want to put in a pipe. Whoops, not that pipe. Wrong button. That pipe. And we're going to want to go and get a line 9. Go ahead and cast that. Whoops, wrong end. We want to go off this front end here. And where is that gyroscope? There it is. And right off the front end of that gyroscope there. And then we're going to grab a curve 5 because we want to drop it down below our center of gravity a little bit. And to do that, we're just going to click here, right on the underside there. Move that. Back like that. Oh, nope, front. There we go, because that's going to give us a better turning. And then click that there, and that end on there. Whoops, let's close that off. All right, and that's what it should look like out the front. And that'll be your turner. Okay, so let's go ahead and look at our center of gravity, because that is going to affect our center of gravity quite a bit. Okay, we're still moving forward. As you can see, it's slightly below the plane. Now what that's going to do is when we turn, it's going to slightly give us some altitude. Just a little bit. Alright, now let's go ahead and back in here. Now let's go ahead and put on some rear weapons. We're going to go back in here and put on the helicopter wings again. There, and that one right there on this side. Alright, let's drop a couple more Hellfires. Now, on the front, I've left these blank. You can put Brownings in there. They're just currently not working right. Attach those facing backwards, and same on the other side. Alright, so now if anyone's chasing us, that'll be a little bit of a deterrent. Alright, we're going to bake. We got center of gravity slowly creeping backwards. Now if we hit the physics button, it's going to fly off the screen again. But as you saw, let me do a slow-mo here for you. It went a little slower, and the angle's getting better. So let's go ahead and head back in here, and we're going to add a couple more fuel tanks. And just find a nice spot for them. Actually, you know what? Let's hang them right from here. And the reason we're kind of putting them towards the back here is we want that weight to move backwards for our center of gravity. There we go. Let's go ahead and bake that. There, slowly, slowly creeping backwards. Let's add some more weapons to this. One thing the aliens do not like are these 88mm cannons. But then again, the Allies didn't like them much either. Okay, so you got to pay attention when you flip this over what side the barrel is on so that you know where to attach it. Let's come back here. Okay, we're going to flip this one over. Since that one, whoa! Okay, so we know the barrel's over here. So I want to attach the middle right on the side over here. And then attach it right there in the middle. So that way it hangs down. And get it facing forward. There you go. And we're going to do the same thing on the other side. This one's going to be a little more difficult, but it's good practice. So we know the barrel's straight down that way, and we want to put it mounted on the other side, facing forward, so we're going to click. That's going to be the top, right there. And in the middle. And then let's go ahead and face that forward. And voila, we now have 88mm cannons. Let's bake that and check out our center gravity. Looking good. So we're going to go ahead, see what else we can add. Oh yeah, we got to add the battery packs. Can't forget that. Would really suck to run out of ammo. Okay, and these can be added pretty much anywhere on the back, wherever they look good. Add one there. There. Now in real life, you never really should put electrical batteries on top of the fuel tank. Just saying. All right. So that center of gravity. Ooh, it's getting there. So from this point, what else can we add that would look cool? Because I'd prefer to put parts on rather than... Oh, we do need a camera. So, let's put one right out the back so we, if anyone's chasing us, we know to shoot at them. There we go. And then we're going to want to... See, monitor's last pitch. There we go. Put a monitor, and I don't really like the monitors right in my face, so what I tend to do is I will do a line 6 and a curve 5 to make a mount, run it right off of this, turn that over there. Down. There we go. come over here to your monitor. Get the side. Click it right there. Then if you hold your shift, whoops. Wrong way. Control, not shift. I always get the two confused. Face it down to you. And that way you still have your full field of view. You just look up to look behind you. Kind of like a rear view mirror. All right. We just run those off standard batteries. Now, if you want, you can also make your seat detach with a detacher and put a parachute on it just in case, you know, you go down in flames. That I'm not too worried about right now until they start implementing that. All right, let's put on some lights. Good to know. Got to make it look nice. Now, you know what? We're going to hang those from here. Where's the front? Got to make sure it looks nice. There we go. Fix that to the front. There we go. Now we got some lights facing the front. Now you can also make these with jet engines. I just prefer to use the prop because when you're fighting the aliens, you don't need a whole lot of speed. You need more of a longevity. And let's go ahead and throw a smoke flare on the back, just, you know, to distinguish friend and foe. But we don't want to cover up the lens. So put one there. I always like to put two, just because I like the color combinations. There we go. What the heck? Whoops. Why don't we throw a Vulcan right off the front? There we go. Now that is going to throw our center of gravity off, but gosh darn it, I want me to have a Vulcan on there. All right, let's go ahead and hit the physics. Oh, way front heavy now. Okay, let's, go ahead and add some ballast here. So I'm going to go ahead and add probably 6. Yes, I clicked a whole bunch more, but we're just going to do 6 real quick. I want to put them right along the end here. Whoops. On the end. It's hard to distinguish those grays sometimes. Alrighty. Click here, here. I find it easier to do it this way sometimes, because when you do it on the part, sometimes it's harder to see it when they show it there. There we go. We're going to bake that. I'm going to go back in here. See, our center of gravity is moving to the back. And we're slowly working that. So let's go ahead and add 6 more ballast. We're going to do 3 on the bottom here. And can you guess where we're going to do the other 3? That's right up on the top. Now, with all that ballast back there, that should help even things out. Oh, look at that. That's almost directly centered. Now, if we turn this on, where does that put us? Okay, so still showing us front heavy. Now, sometimes the center of gravity isn't always accurate as to the weight of the blimp. So, we just want to keep adding weight to the back end. In various spots where you can fit it. Let's add some more fuel tanks. As you can see, it is back, but when we hit this, we're still a little front heavy, but look how slow that's moving up. We are almost where we want to be. Let's go back in here. I think from here, I'm just going to add some ballast, because we have enough fuel. Let's add one there. One there, and a couple more on this side. And hopefully that'll be enough to even us out. Okay, we're heavy enough, but we're still front heavy. So let's go ahead and I'm going to take this front fuel tank off, that one right there. Let's go ahead and say we're going to look where our fuel is. Now this is a fine tuning process at this point. Okay, still front heavy, but we can add some weight on the back. Now don't worry about it being too heavy, because you do want to be able to go down. And you'll have plenty of lift with the two engines for upwards movement. Let's add one right there. Now remember, always add in the same spot on both sides. Slowly, I think if we add three more, probably. Put one right there. Right there. Let's hang one off the middle of the engine there. We'll go over here. Still front heavy. So that's good. Now you can also, you know, if you want to take some weapons off, we can do that. Because that Vulcan, I have a feeling, is pretty heavy. Let's see what happens if we take that off. Yeah, that's more even. So, you know what we could do? Let's go ahead and bring that Vulcan back. But we're going to mount it. Could do. Yeah, we're gonna be creative here. If I can get pipes, and we're gonna go to that one we made. It's the Rec 3, the one we used as the ribs. We're gonna put that in, and we're gonna attach it right there. Move it forward. is, gosh darn it, I want my Vulcans. Drop me a Vulcan. As illogical as it is. Alright, now we want to move this. We want to hang it back so that most of the weight is focused on the back. And now I got me some Vulcans. Let's check the weight. Nice. Look at that. Almost perfect. We just got to do a little bit of fine tuning. I think I'm going to take my line 25 now. It may not be the prettiest thing, but it will work. We go to parts. We're going to drop two ballast. As you saw, I put it in between the fuel tanks there. That there. We're going to put one right on the other side. Now what this is going to do is, because I've moved it the weight back so far, it's going to make more of a difference on the center of gravity. Let's bake that. Oh, that looks good. Now we can move this up and see it much better. Still slightly. Let's see what we can do to adjust that. I'd say throw another ballast on the back. When in doubt, add more weight. Oh, that looks good. So now we're going to go into fine tuning. Alright, so let's. Whoops, exit physics mode. I always just like to bake it to start. Alright, so what we're going to want to do here. I'm just going to hook everything up to the single seat. We're just going to do it all in one fell swoop. Let's start with the fuel tanks. I always like to make sure everything has fuel first. We should have... Oh, there's supposed to be five. Okay, so we have our fuel tanks. Let's go ahead and work on downward thrust. We're not going to set our flap input at all, just for the simple fact we don't want to be worrying about moving. Because that's just going to rotate our blimp rather than turning it. So, we're going to go ahead. I want to put the up-down on my throttle up to, throttle down to, because we want that separate from our forward momentum. And it's all activated. Everything looks good there. I'm not going to link RPMs in that until we're all set and everything's done. So we want to invert thrust because the engine is pointing backwards versus forward. And we're not going to worry about that. And we're going to leave that at throttle up one, throttle down one. Okay, let's get our front. All right, now with these, we want to attach one to boost one. One to boost two, and we'll adjust in the keybinds what those are. Okay, so we have all our engines set. Let's go ahead and link our guns, auto aim it off of the chair. And everything else looks good. Let's do the same with our cannons up here. We're going to auto aim them off the chair. And those will fire the same as these guns, so concentrated fire. Alright, all those. Okay, we're gonna only select these front four. And actually, you know what, I take that back. We're gonna get the top ones. And fire input activate 2. Fire input for the bottom ones activate 3. And for the rear ones, I put activate 4. There we go. So we have our fuel hooked up. We have our engines. Let's, okay, those automatically link. Okay, so let's grab our batteries. We're going to link those to all the Hellfires. The camera. The guns. Essentially everything but that front gyroscope. Should be everything attached but that gyroscope. The only thing we want to attach to that gyroscope are those two side batteries. All right, let's go ahead and click that off. Then we'll get to those batteries here. And we're going to link that just to the gyroscope. Okay, that's activated. And we're just going to do a thing of the camera over here. Alright. We want to link the camera to that monitor there. Everything's activated, so go over here, hit control. That monitor should turn on. That looks good. Engine's on. Alright, let's turn our physics. I'm going to turn on the RPMs on our... There he goes. You see, we are moving. Getting our lift. All right. Currently, that's... So... I'm going to change that one just because I currently have it set up for that. Change those boost 1, boost 2. Now we're going to go into key binds, only show used keys. Now for our boost 1, as you can see, there's none in and no input, so I'm going to go ahead and have that going to the right. And then our boost 2 already set to the left. So let's go back. Now when I go back in here and control, I should be able to turn left and right just using that. Now if you want, you can also set this on a separate control so you don't have any forward momentum at all. But it looks like we are about ready to take this out. And if you find that you want a higher lift rate, we can always take these Vulcans off and take extra weight off, just however you want, because I just have this thing heavily loaded. Alrighty, so we're going to bake it. Whoops, we got to exit the physics mode. And let's drop that down. There we go. Turn everything off. Bake. Let's take a pretty picture. All right, I'm going to take this outside. We'll take it for a spin, and I will be right back. What? What's this? We're not where we started? That's okay. You got to find the aliens on your own. All right. We're going to go ahead and throw out our blimp here. Give it a second. It's going to bounce up because I threw it at an angle. There we go. Turn everything on. And all I'm doing right now is I can't look around or anything. I'm just mainly testing, make sure we get plenty of lift. We can turn. Can even slide along the ground. Pretending we're a race car. Ever wonder how you can get those? That's one way. Alright. On that note, we're going to jump out. Bye-bye! Bye-bye! Alright, so we know it works. Now we're going to do the last bit of fine-tuning. Alright. Just making sure everything looks good on there. Okay, there's currently nothing on there. That's right. So we're going to look around. We want to show the crosshair so that our guns will show up. We want to show our speed, our altitude. Let's edit those real quick. I like to put my altitude right here at the top. There we go. Now, because all of our batteries are linked, all of our fuel is linked, we only really need to pick one to show that fuel. Only need to pick one battery pack. Show that power. Yeah, we're gonna put the fuel here. You can put these wherever you want on the screen. Alright. Now I wanna pick the top ones here, because they're linked. And since I'm firing at the same time, I only need to link one of them. I do these individually so I know exactly where I can put these. So I know that's the top ones. Let's link the show missiles there. And that is the bottom one, so now I know how many I have left firing. Oh, and one thing I do want to fix, I want to put this in the center, because otherwise it'll put it at the bottom. And this, the screen is something you just work with and you'll get it figured out after a while. Alright. And then let's get the rear ones. And we'll just have those back here. That real quick. Alright, did it once over. It looks like we are all set. That is everything. We're going to go ahead and leave again. Let's throw this out here and we'll have our final test of the vehicle with weapon systems and everything. There we go. As you can see, we have our missiles above and below. So, well, it looks like we'll have to adjust that. You can either turn the camera around, or turn the adjust the setting on the camera, or turn the monitor around. So we're gonna go top ones, bottom ones, rear ones. Nice. Oh, one thing I didn't do. I forgot. We gotta set the RPM on the engine so we know how fast we're going. So yes, I forgot something. So link the RPM there. We're gonna edit that. And since that's the rear RPM, we're just going to set it right here next to this one, right above that. And we only need to link one of those because those are linked. Show the RPM there. And that'll be our bottom one. All right. I think this time we are officially done. We can take this thing up and go for a test drive. As you see, it balances on this perfect. Let's turn everything on. Alright. As you can see, our bottom one. We're going to crank that up. As you see, we are gaining altitude. Slowly but surely. Now, like I said, if you wanted to gain altitude a lot faster, you can remove some of these guns. Wrong one. Alright. There we go. Probably have to take that camera, drop it back a little bit, but that's easy enough to do. Like I said, it's all about little bits of fine-tuning. As you see how these jets make it so much easier to turn. As you notice, our speed begins to slow down dramatically when all those guns are going off. Alright, let's take a for a spin over here. Still keep moving forward. We're going to drop our engines. We start descending. All right, we're going to slow down here. And just come in for a nice, soft landing. Shut her down, and we're good to go. Whoops. Climbed back in. All right, like I said, we can just go in here if we want to take off. So you don't want so many missiles, or you want to take off, you know. Say we don't want, we decide, nah, we don't want the Gatling cannons, because we can't aim them for some, you know, for some odd reason. We decide we don't want all that firepower. Alright, so we just save. We've gotten rid of it. Let's go ahead and lift that up there. You can see still pretty even, because we had it back there. But, whoops, exit physics mode. When we go into here, now we've removed those Vulcan cannons. Which I don't know why you do, because that would be illogical, but... Hop in the seat, turn everything on. Now if you'll notice, we're already starting to rise. At half the RPMs. See how we're rising at a much higher rate of speed. So you can just adjust the weight, because if you have yourself at like exactly -1 FPS for your buoyancy, then you're going to raise up really quick, but coming down is going to be the hard part. But you can always solve that with a detachable chair and parachute. Alright, let's crank it up again. Like I said, you can also add more engines for more speed. You can add a jet engine. Got a pretty good turning radius for, you know, a blimp. Now, if you do put the tail wings on, you do not have this kind of turning radius. I will guarantee you that. All right, let's come in over here. See if we can't land right on. Yeah, we just turned everything off and boom, look at that, perfect landing. All right, well, I hope you enjoyed today's episode, and go out, build your own blimp, take some pictures, and let us all see it. Have a good one.